Live from the studio at the Northwest Florida School of Biblical Studies, this is Have a Bible Question, where you are part of the program. Now, let's go to the Bible for answers to your Bible questions.
All right, we're going to go back. I had a question come in very early. We have a bunch. We really got to get busy. I lost it. Where'd it go? Man, I didn't know it was this. Okay, here we go. I have a friend who is not saved but is open-minded. Is there a movie that I can expose them to about being born again? I want to take a minute with that idea. One, a born again. Two, the concept of a movie. Three, I want to recommend a couple books. When I say that, one, I always emphasize Bible.
Amen.
And Tina, if you will send us a messenger through Messenger, send me that address. I'll be happy to send them a Bible. And in the back of that Bible, it actually has some guides that will help them be able to search the scriptures, that they can look up in there. It's, World Bible School.
Mm-hmm.
They print that out to try and help. And if you'll send me the address of that person, I'll be happy to mail you that as well, along with another book called Transformed. And World Video Bible School does that book, and it's about a journey of a young man coming to understand what the true church is and how to be saved, and leads to his conversion to Christ. And I'll be happy to mail a copy of that book to him as well. Those are available through World Bible School and World Video Bible School.
Yeah, two different things.
Mm-hmm. Two separate organizations. I emphasize the Bible. That's number one. These are just guides. As far as a movie, I don't really know of a movie. And I caution with movies just because we tend to get people to watch things.
Well, you mentioned World Video Bible School.
Well, yeah.
There's a movie that was produced by World Video Bible School. If you just type that in Google, World Video Bible School, you can go to their catalog, and there's a movie that they have called Bound. And it
I forgot
is
about that.
Yeah, it's a story about a young lady who winds up in a bad situation. And let me just, without ruining the movie for you, it doesn't go where you think it's going.
Got some great actors. I think Troy was in that movie.
No, I don't remember being in that movie. Some friends of ours.
Oh, I thought you were in that movie.
No.
Well, you were in something else.
I was in something else, yeah. I played a drunk. in another World Video Bible School.
In another Christian movie.
Against type, right? Yeah.
So, anyway, it's about this young lady, and they wind up having a Bible study with her, and you watch that go through the process and everything. It's a wonderful movie. World Video Bible School, the movie Bound.
Yep. And so there's that one. But I always caution a lot of movies now. World Video Bible School does a good job with the one you're talking about. I've watched it. It's very accurate. But a lot of movies start to take a lot of theatrics and drama, and that's what makes movies. But they start taking too much creative licensing. And so I always caution people when it comes to the idea of movies, and really want to push people back towards something that's going to push them to the Word. And I find that to be more effective when you're trying to reach out to somebody. That's why I'm willing to send you some material that I think would help. We don't get it mixed up with Homeward Bound, is what Alan Jury said.
That's right. That's a totally different type of movie.
But I keep hearing sounds. I'm trying to figure out whether.
Sorry, I'm trying to get some stuff over here.
Squirrel. Oh, that's you. Okay, good.
Squirrel. Yeah. You're right, because there are some religious movies that are very popular. There we go. On the screen, you can now see that book by Lance Mosher that's called Transform. That's the book that that
everybody wants to know.
About.
Everybody I know that knows Keith Mosher is like, oh, is that Keith? No relation. I said the same thing whenever I saw that. Different Mosher's.
And there is, you can see the movie Bound, what that looks like. And with, just seeing right there, with Bound also comes another DVD called Searching for Truth.
John Moore does that one.
Yes. And so that would be very worth your while to get that. So going back to these Christian movies, there are many Christian movies that are faith-based movies, but unfortunately, they're from denominational backgrounds. And so when they get to the idea of salvation or being born again, what they're teaching is not congruent with the scriptures. It does not match what the scriptures teach. And so you have to be really careful with those. That's why he's playing a politician here and not answering the question directly in that, but because there are some, I'm just messing with you, Guyton.
Well, I don't even know what you said.
No clue as to what's going on here. He's still hearing noises or something. Yeah.
Well, we're going to take the idea of being born again question.
Okay.
At this point, I wanted to deal with what are some resources. Now let's take the born again. Now, are Christians born again?
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, Nicodemus.
That's right. John chapter 3, Jesus said, "You must be born again." And Nicodemus said, "How can a man enter a womb once he's been born?"
Is that always the same, though, as what people are implying when they talk about being a born again Christian?
No.
All right. So, what's the difference that we have?
Oh, I'm just answering the question. Oh, go ahead.
Yeah, I was going to let you go ahead and expound. Come on now.
Well, I guess. And it may not be where you were going, but just the idea of, well, how is one born again? At what point does one experience the new birth? I would just go down that route, so I don't want to hijack that. Go ahead.
No, go ahead. I love where you're going.
All right, so typically denominational, you talked about movies and so forth. So the denominational idea, the prominent one, is to accept Jesus as your Savior, accept Him into your heart as your personal Savior, and then that's done via prayer or maybe not prayer. It depends on who you're talking to, but typically that's the scenario that's given, and the fact is that's nowhere in Scripture. Mm-hmm. We can search from the front to the back, and we cannot find any command or example of it. So,
well, if you go, and like, I just did a quick search to Christianity. I just said, what is a born-again Christian? Because I wanted that general... what they mean, because I know when we teach, we're going to teach, this is what the Bible says. And obviously, when you read John chapter 3, and I am writing that, right, Nicodemus? Yep. John 3?
Yeah.
All right, there we go. Verse 1, starting. Going through the rest of the chapter.
Yes, chapter 3 does start with verse 1. Yeah. Good job.
Yes. Anyway, so whenever he's talking about being born again, obviously, we're talking about baptism and this cognizant decision that's done by an adult in order to become a follower of Jesus Christ, to be spiritually reborn. But if you look this up, Christianity.com says the phrase born-again Christian is frequently misinterpreted. I find that funny. looking at its primary reference, we see that its meaning is not about physical birth, but about experiencing a spiritual renewal. Now, a spiritual rebirth, I would agree with. But he goes on, he says, it is an expression used by many Protestants, which, by the way, is that alone is not really a biblical concept, to define the moment or process of fully accepting faith in Jesus Christ, which I would be okay with that if they understood that faith without works is dead being alone.
Right.
But it goes on and it says, it is an experience when the teachings of Christianity and Jesus become real and the born again acquire a personal relationship with God. And then it goes on and talks about the idea of the sinner's prayer, because it says, how do you be born again? And then it just simply says, you know, that you Jesus is the way. And so when you choose to receive or reject God's gift, and it mentions nowhere about baptism. So how in the world are you supposed to be born again, which is the whole concept of putting Christ, putting away the old man, Colossians chapter 3, Romans chapter 6, in order to rise up and be like him because you crucified the fleshly to be spiritual.
Consider, I don't want to interrupt too much, but just the idea of, I've heard people talk about the vagueness of this particular kind of salvation to the point that every time they're in an assembly and you know, like a funeral or whatever, and the preacher says, you know, close your eyes and raise your hand if you want to accept Jesus, it's almost every, even though they've done it 100 times before, they're going to do it again. It's just kind of a vague experience as opposed to what you were just contrasting these things with and just describing, you know, birth is not just this vague experience that, you know.
That's right.
It's pretty significant. You know when it happens, but this other is just like, I accepted him, I think. what does that even
mean? I've talked to people that have questioned that. They're like, well, I thought that I had a spiritual experience, but I'm questioning if I did or not. And I thought, that's the thing about biblical baptism. You know when you did it.
Right. They had an emotional experience.
They had an emotion, and that's what's based on many times.
Which is momentary.
Yes.
So another thing, too, when it comes talking about being born again, you know, there are terms that the Bible uses that I believe sometimes this comes from. For example, in 1 Corinthians chapter 3, Paul writes, "And I, brethren, could not speak to you as spiritual people, but as to carnal, as babes in Christ." And so that's kind of where this ideology comes from of being born again. There's also, you mentioned this through Romans, but also in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation." That's essentially saying born again. They're new, and you can just tie John chapter 3, you know, in there, and Colossians 3 with that as well of, okay, well, there's that born again experience. So to answer your question you said earlier, are we born again? Yes, a Christian is born again. But just as a child, and that's what Jesus was explaining to Nicodemus, as a child passes through water and blood, you know, we pass through water and blood. That literal water, which represents the blood of Christ, which washes us from all sin, Acts 22, verse 16.
And going back to his vagueness and building on what you said, going back to Romans 6, you know, I love this chapter because he's drawing this contrast that, you know, yes, we have the grace of God, but that doesn't mean it's a license to sin.
Amen.
You know, I always say I want to build me a sermon that's going to look like the intro to a James Bond thing, license to kill, license to sin.
License to sin.
You know, and so verse 3, "Know ye not that so many of us as were baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death?" Then he goes in Romans 6, 4, "Therefore we are buried with him by baptism into death, that like as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we should also walk in the newness of life. For if we've been planted together in the likeness of his death, we shall be also in the likeness of his resurrection." I love this verse 6. "Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin, so that we can be," verse 8, "that we can live with him." And so listen to that confidence.
Mm-hmm.
He's very specific of saying, you know who you are because of these specific acts. That's, I appreciate what you brought up about the vagueness. There is no question about at what point.
Right. And add verse 17 in there too, in that same chapter. Verse 17 says that, "Thanks be to God that you obeyed that form of doctrine."
Mm-hmm.
That's very important because that word form there means model or pattern. It's the word topos, and it literally means what you just said. He was buried, all right? He died, he was buried, and he raised again. And that's what we do in literal baptism. We go under, we're buried, and we're raised again. We're following that topos, that pattern of the doctrine.
And that's where, you know, born again in that question, you know, is there a movie? I didn't think about Bound. I'm sorry.
Why we do this together.
Yeah. So there is a movie. There are some books. We'll get you the material. Don't want to forget Bible Correspondence Course. If you want to do that, we offer that to try and help somebody see what the scripture says. Can you be born again? Yes, but be very cautious that don't just go search born again and find those things, because oftentimes it's used in the wrong sense. We understand that you are to be born again. You have this spiritual birth that takes place, the being born of the Spirit. But it is that cognizant decision to follow after Jesus. And it happens at the point of baptism, mm-hmm. when our sins are washed away.